In this module, we'll list the most common optical fiber cable types and the fire ratings associated with their indoor or in-building use. There are three considerations when selecting an optical fiber cable: the type or types of fiber strands the cable will contain, the total number of strands required for both current and future needs, and the physical construction of the cable itself to suit the environment where it will be placed. Here's a quick overview of the most widely used types of cable constructions for installations within individual buildings and between buildings on a campus. The first type of cable construction is loose tube, where 250 micron fiber strands are placed in buffer tubes within the cable, usually in groups of 12. This construction is routinely selected for aerial or underground outdoor cables used to interconnect multiple buildings on a campus, with gel or tape used to prevent moisture infiltration. If necessary, additional physical protection can be provided by one or more layers of corrugated steel armor between layers of jacketing. It's also possible to select a loose tube construction for indoor use when the intent is to field connectorize the fiber strands using multi-fiber or MPO connectors, as shown here. The second type of cable construction is tight buffer, where the 250 micron fiber strands are individually buffered or tightly covered with a protective layer, making their external diameter 900 microns, or just under 1 millimeter, which is equal to 1,000 microns. This construction is widely used for indoor cables as well as for fire-rated outdoor or campus cables, which can be extended and routed within buildings after entry without the need to transition to a fire-rated cable in the entrance room or entrance space. As with loose tube cables, additional physical protection for both indoor and outdoor tight buffer cables can be provided by a layer of corrugated steel armor between two layers of jacketing. Armored indoor cables are ideal for use in shared cable trays, where they may end up beneath other heavy cable bundles. In such cases, the armoring prevents excessive signal loss due to the higher crushing forces along the length of the fiber cables. Note that most manufacturers also offer hybrid constructions, containing both single-mode and multi-mode fibers. The third type of cable construction is ribbon, where the fiber strands are attached to each other in a row, creating a flat or pliable strip of fibers suitable for multi-fiber mass fusion splicing, as shown here. The ribbon construction is typically selected for very high fiber counts, all the way up to nearly 7,000 strands in a single cable. Note that the highest densities numbering in the thousands are typically associated with data center and service provider facilities. The fourth type of cable construction is pre-terminated, where the fiber cable is cut to the desired length and connectorized at one or both ends at the factory by the manufacturer, essentially the equivalent of a long fiber pigtail or patch cord. After the cable is installed, the connectorized ends are inserted into adapters mounted on fiber patch panels or cassettes at one or both ends, which eliminates all connectorization time and minimizes termination errors. Note that pre-terminated or pre-term cabling was initially developed as a solution for data center computer rooms, but it can also be used in commercial building equipment rooms or any other environment where the required cable lengths can be accurately measured. Next, we'll summarize the fire ratings for indoor-only and indoor-outdoor fiber cables. In order to help prevent the rapid spread of fire within buildings, all indoor or indoor-outdoor cables, including optical fiber ones, must be fire-rated and installed according to all applicable local building and electrical codes. As listed here, there are four designations for optical fiber cabling: OFNR, OFNP, OFCR, and OFCP. Non-conductive or conductive refers to the absence or presence of any metallic elements in the cable. For example, an armored optical fiber cable or a composite cable containing both fibers and twisted pairs would both be classified as conductive. Riser and plenum are terms used to identify the intended location of the cable within a building. If the cable is to be placed in an area where environmental air for building occupants is flowing, it must have a plenum rating. For example, the network cables placed horizontally above a suspended ceiling that's used to return warm air to the air conditioning system in an office building would have to be rated plenum, whereas the cables placed vertically between floors in the same building would require a riser rating. That's it. We're done. Thanks for watching.